to meet Hugh Hefner in half an hour, then at 11.55, snuggle up to the smooth sound of Natalie Cole live in London. That's all on the way on BBC One, after they think it's all over.
They think it's all over, and Gary and Rory are one down in the series with one to play. With Gary and Rory is a World Cup and Premiership referee who gets up to 100 rude messages on his answer phone after every game. It says, please leave your bleeps after the bleep. Graham Paul. Should be more booze than that. With Sharron and Jonathan is a former top 400 metre runner who was awarded the MBE in 1991, the services to the bronze medal industry. Roger Black. We kick things off with Sporting Bluff, Gary, Rory and Graham. It's the goal that never was, which denied Crystal Palace and helped Leeds United reach the FA Cup sixth round.
For Butterfield, who's onside. Now can he find someone else? Johnson is there! It must be in! Platt off the line by Mills! Goodness me, Rihilati over the bar! Crystal Palace incensed. And that looks like it went over the line before it hit Mills.
Now your question involves Leeds United sponsors Strongbow. What can you tell us about Strongbow's latest US ad campaign, Sharron's team?
Okay, Strongbow's ad campaign was banned because of the activities of certain Leeds players.
Strongbow's ad campaign was banned because it featured a longbow.
Strongbow's ad campaign was banned for promoting football hooliganism.
So, was Strongbow's campaign banned because of Leeds players, a longbow, or football hooliganism? Gary's team.
Well, just what a great honour it is to have Graham Pohl, one of our top referees, on our team. Any Arsenal supporters here? Yeah. You do recognise him, so you remember that when he sent Ray Parlour off against Newcastle. Can you explain that decision, Gary? Any Stoke City supporters here?
Yeah.
Because you've had a bit of a bad time at Stoke as well, didn't you, Graham?
Yeah, sadly.
Oh, you're the only referee that has a song dedicated to you, aren't you, Graham?
So I understand.
Do you like to sing it to us?
No.
Go on, go.
Oh, Graham Paul, you're a...
sausage roll?
Nosshole.
I didn't know you were a referee, I apologise. When I heard that Graham Paul was on the show, I thought it was a mediocre porn star.
Talking of sex and refereeing, it's not true that on your wedding night, Graham, that your wife said, oh, Graham, go for your red card, quick. That's the dirtiest tackle I've ever seen.
Actually, could you referee, though, Gary? Because actually, they're fitter than footballers, aren't they?
They reckon they are, because they just jog around for an hour and a half.
We cover more ground than any footballer on the field of play during the 90 minutes.
You'd think you'd see the occasional incident then, wouldn't you?
So it's hooliganism,
Leeds players,
hooliganism,
longbow. I'll go for hooliganism.
Okay, so you think that Jonathan was telling the truth? Let's see if you're right.
Well done. 3 points.
Jonathan was in the right. Strongbow's ad agency in the US thought it would be a really good idea to go with the slogan, helping fuel soccer riots for almost 40 years. The cider company vetoed the idea, but the ad agency went ahead anyway, and now snatch squads have been deployed in bars across America to recover and destroy beer mats with the offending slogan. The FA have taken measures to curb football violence. Controversial games now have early kickoffs. Alcohol is banned in the stands. And Sir Alex Ferguson has to wear slippers in the dressing room. Sharron, Jonathan and Roger, here's Peter Waterfield winning gold for England in the diving at the Commonwealth Games last summer.
And it is a good dive. And listen to the roar of the crowd.
Now, in order to help popularise the sport of diving, what rule change was made recently, Gary's team?
The diving authorities have legalised bombing.
The diving authorities have legalised the bikini.
The diving authorities have legalised the use of music by competitors.
Diving, is that, that's not really a sport though,
oh,
is it?
Yeah.
It's just like falling with your hands out, that's not a proper sport. I mean, you go off the board, you're not going to go up, are you?
What?
How hard can it be? You just got to keep your legs together, haven't you? Well, maybe for some of us that might be hard.
I'm not saying, anyone here. I was thinking about art.
That's not you, it's just wishful thinking. Ooh. I'll tell you how you can make diving more interesting. Two words, shallow end.
Well,
you'd watch though, wouldn't you? You'd watch.
I think music. What do you think? Come on.
It's music, isn't it?
Okay,
it's
so you think that Rory was telling the truth? Let's see if you're right. No. No, in fact, Graham was correct. Swimming's governing body, FINA, hopes legalising bombing will encourage people of limited ability to participate in the sport. Yeah? Leading British divers plan to boycott this year's European Championships as a protest. The Americans are completely in favour of the introduction of bombing, although, judging by their record, they'll end up bombing the pool next door. Diving... bit of politics. Diving surrounds itself with technical terms. A body bent at the waist with straight legs is called a pike. A body curled with knees brought up to the chest is known as a tuck. And a sudden, unconvincing plummet when there's no one near you is called a hesky. Bombing will henceforth be known as a forward jump with tuck. So next time you're thrown out of the pool for petting, you can say, actually, I was attempting a nylon parting with double-digit insertion. Rory here has actually been thrown out of a pool for heavy petting, but tragically, it was the sea lion pool at London. At the end of that round, Sharon's team have no points and Gary's team have three. It's handbags time now, all about sporting spats. Gary's team, your wrangle involves the two Wimbledon singles champions of 1992.
Revenge is sweet. So the emotions overcome him.
So why the marital disharmony between two of tennis's all-time greats, Gary's team?
Surely it's just because they're married.
Yeah, are you married?
I am, yes.
Yeah, does she ever dress up as a referee and sort of...
No, she doesn't.
...book you for diving in the box or anything like that? So it's Agassi and Steffi.
They're falling out. They're falling out.
He is the face of T-Mobile, isn't he?
Yes.
And she is the face of Concord. Is it because she gets up at 4 in the morning and sneaks down the swimming pool to put a towel on a sun lounger? Is he a good-looking bloke, Andre Agassi, would you say?
Yeah.
Not as good-looking as Roger Black, though.
Or Graham Pole.
Graham Pole knows the answers.
Yeah,
top ref.
Come on, Graham. There's one thing I must make very clear. There's no cheating going on while I'm on this side.
Okay, fair enough.
That's 25 quid wasted.
Have you ever been offered a
Have you ever been offered a
bomb? You must have been somewhere.
Never.
Ever?
Never, ever. Never, ever. But I'm still...
So they're all genuine mistakes?
Yeah.
Scarcely believable.
I don't know much about football, but are you... I'm listening to what the fellas are saying here. Am I right in thinking you are shit then? Because I...
He does a very difficult job very badly.
Come on, let's have an answer.
It was something to do with... I think it was his idea. He wanted to play mixed doubles with her as a comeback kind of thing. And they had a big row about that.
Yeah, I'll give you 3 points for that. Yeah, well done. Well done, Graham. You've probably ridden out the referee's stuff now. You're there now. It's all because of a bet Agassi made before winning the Australian Open. He announced to journalists before the tournament that if he won, Graf would partner him in the mixed doubles at the French Open. The trouble is, he forgot to tell Steffi first. And as a further bet, if Tim Henman wins the Australian Open, I'll have the operation and partner him in the mixed doubles.
Come on, Tim!
Amazingly, at the age of 47, Martina Navratilova won the mixed doubles at the Australian Open this year. There may be flecks of grey in that beard of hers, but she's still got it. Sharron's team, here's your warring couple in action.
Your far side, coming in on it, no!
So that's Gary Lineker back when he was good and Atomic Kitten singing It's Okay, which of course it isn't. But how has Gary made an enemy of band member Liz McLarnon, Sharron's team?
You know, I would like just to take a second here to talk about Gary in a positive way, because last week I was watching Blue Peter, purely for research, and I saw Gary was on it talking about charity. As we all know, Gary Lineker has a heart as big as a disabled toilet. I must admit, when we tuned in, we didn't know it was you. I was only watching because I couldn't make it out, and when I saw you, I thought it was that elephant from that classic clip, you know, when he wins on the board.
You guys have been on Blue Peter, haven't you? 4x4.
Yeah, we did.
Every day.
Yeah, it was good. Chris Akabusi got shat on by the tortoise.
I thought he was meant to be fast. You thought he'd seen it and got away.
I think it's something to do with Gary playing for Everton and them particularly liking Liverpool and not prepared to sign something before.
No, hand it across.
Can't give you that. I'm going to have to hand it across.
No, don't hand it across.
I think it's general complaint about Gary from Everton supporters, in fact, that he has played for them and played successfully for Everton.
Best team ever played for. You came second
in an FA Cup final when you played
best
for Everton.
Best team ever played for. I loved it.
He never talks about it in interviews.
I'll give you a bonus point for that. Well done, Rory. It is all because of Liz McLarnon's loyalty to her beloved Everton. According to the Daily Star, Liz says Gary can never have an autograph for his sons as she can't forgive him for leaving Everton in 1986. Liz McLarnon's favourite Everton player of all time is Duncan Ferguson. She says he kept his Everton tattoo even when he went to Newcastle. That proves his heart is with Everton. No, Liz, that proves that tattoos are impossible to remove. Gary here was our team captain for 99 of the first 100 shows. In the other show, Mark Lawrenson filled his seat, which is the only time that's happened in public. And at the end of that round, Sharron's team have no points and Gary's team have 7. No points? In the next round, we show some events from an international sporting competition and ask what other disciplines were involved. Gary's team, you'll recognise the Naked Olympics, held annually on Maslin Beach, Adelaide.
When I eat it.
So, that was the sack race, naked donut eating, the three-legged race, and best bum. What other events haven't we shown? 1 point for each one you get, up to a maximum of 3.
But how can you have a nude Olympic donut eating? I mean, if you have ring donuts in an Olympic nude thing, you don't eat them hanging off strings, do you? I mean, come on. It's an event for the ladies. I mean, Nespa?
I gave him a bit of class.
I made it classy, yeah. And we can sell this show to France.
Yeah. Put the donuts on your cook.
Yes, what? I'll shop me load over tits. Comme si, comme ça.
He was a right save Ray.
The relay must have been chaos, mustn't it? Some of the blokes love that. Ooh, just give it to me.
I have.
So you're up to the events.
What about the
100 metres?
So you've got to hand it to him for the delivery, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen.
Javelin.
Yes, one.
I hesitate
Egg
to make.
Spoon.
No.
Hesitate to mention tug of war.
Two.
Relay.
Three. Well done. Relay. 3 points. Yeah. Excellent. Yes, the other naked events are the javelin, the relay, tossing the frisbee, Miss Nude Maslin, tug of war, and nude body painting. There are now plans for a naked Winter Olympics to be held in Switzerland, but it's going to be a much smaller event. Roger here took part in this year's Naked Olympics. We were hoping to get a full frontal photo, but unfortunately he was obscured by the winning American in front of him. Your games are the Eskimo Olympics, held since 1961 in Fairbanks, Alaska. Now, that was, of course, the Alaskan high kick, the ear weight pull, and the blanket toss. So what other events are there? 1 point for each.
And what toss?
The blanket toss.
Does that involve Michael Jackson?
No! No, no, and thrice no.
Bear killing?
Nope.
Bear buggering?
Nope. Wrestling? Wrestling covered in whale fat blubber?
Whale riding? Bubbling.
Nope.
They ride seal?
Nope.
They ride seals like horses. I've seen them. I've seen them do it in cartoons.
Fishing?
No.
They must fish. The Eskimos fish all the time. You don't fish.
Doesn't mean it's one of the sports in the Eskimo Olympics.
Fish eating?
No.
Fish catching?
No.
Fish juggling?
No.
Fish smelling?
No.
Fish skinning?
No.
Fish wearing?
No, nothing to do with fish.
They must be. Their whole culture is based on ice and fish. I've given you any number of ice-based events. You've turned them down because you're in a bad mood. I'm now giving the fish rule, and you're not giving me space to work here.
No.
Give us a chance.
No.
It's clearly fish-based.
It's
fish.
A distraction.
Fish riding.
No,
a big fish.
No, not a big fish.
Fish
wear,
make a clothes out of
no,
fish.
Trillion
suits out of say, don't wear that fish. It doesn't suit you. You're too fat for that
no,
fish.
No.
The scales make you look fat.
No.
Make the scales go
no.
that way.
No.
Fish cooking?
No.
Are you seriously telling me there's not one fish-based event at the Eskimo Olympics?
Yes.
You're crazy. You've lost the support of the audience. You've lost their respect. There's got to be a fish-based sport on the Eskimo Olympics.
I'll give you a point if you shut the up!
1 point.
And you don't know any either, do you?
Yeah, we do.
Oh, come on.
Okay.
Go on.
Synchronised beaver defrosting.
No! Yeah, you're not going to get a point for the same reasons. No way. The other events are...
Oh, chicken.
No,
chicken.
You've read it now. The other events are stick pulling, toe kicking, arm pulling, 1 foot high kick, 2 foot high kick, the kneel jump, drop the bomb, seal skinning.
I said seal skinning!
No, you said seal clogging!
You said seal clogging! Yes, I said it.
You said it!
I said seal skinning.
You said steel clubbing.
Left.
I lost it. Roger here took part in this year's Eskimo Olympics. We were hoping to show you a photo of him in sealskins, but unfortunately, he was obscured by the winning American in front of him. And at the end of that round, Sharron's team have 1 point and Gary's team have 10. Time for our regulars to faff about in blindfolds as we play Field of Sportsmen. Gary and Rory, you're up first this week. If you'd like to take your positions, take your blindfolds with you. You have 90 seconds to work out who's at your fingertips. Can we have our first mystery guest, please? Your time starts now. Something else.
He touches your breath. Hit him.
Ow! I haven't even touched your breath yet.
What's happening?
Is it alive?
What's happening?
Ladies,
which
munch? Oh, sorry. What was that? Felt like an eyeball. Oh, are you okay? Whoever you are.
Going a bit hard, you have.
He's all doing.
Fuck me.
A bunch of women. It must be a rugby team.
You got cauliflower tits there, dear.
Ladies rugby team.
Which one?
I don't know, it's
Wasps.
Saracens
Wasps.
It's national England.
Yes, it's the correct answer. It's the England Ladies Rugby Union. One at the back pulled down her shorts and she had high Nick written on the cheeks of her arse. And I'm not being rude if I say she could have put Nicholas, actually. Frosty?
I think you should show us all, not just him.
No, don't do it! Very gay, Frosty.
The amazing thing is, round the front, she had a little picture of me.
Okay. The master, Sharron and Jonathan, up you go.
Hold it.
Right, Vinny.
Okay, blindfolds on. And can we have our second mystery guest, please?
What's that?
Hold on.
What's that? Hold on.
Oh! Okay.
Hey, hold on.
What time? Start now.
Right, you go in. You do
I'm
this
scared.
One.
No, you go first.
No, ladies first. I am a guest.
Oh,
there's a mat.
Oh,
I've got one leg. I think it's a leg.
Yeah. An arm.
It's a midget leg.
What's that?
It's a leg growing out of a leg. It's like some genetic mutation. What's this bit? What's that? This is some sort of weird gathering. It's like a swingers party at Gary's house. I think this might be from Billy Elliot, the director's cut.
Sorry.
Hey?
I'll go and get that, help.
That is how to get your nipple pierced.
What's this?
Hold on! Ladies, get up! Get your hands! Hold on! Hold on.
It's got to be some sort of recipe.
Go on then.
Yep.
I can't stand up! I'm putting holes in everything!
It was, in fact, Douglas Thompson, the British freestyle wrestling champion, and Paul Ivins, the runner-up. Douglas Thompson and Paul Ivins.
Did we get a point?
No, just 1 point for
you
wrestler.
Are so down on
the wrestler. Shall I give him 3 points? Yeah. Okay, so at the end of that round, Gary's team have 13 points and Sharon's team have 4. We end the series by playing the name game. The team in the lead goes first, which means that Gary's team go first. Pass those along to Rory, please. As many names as you can in 90 seconds, starting.
Whoa.
Now.
Face like Concord, German tennis player. Nice legs. Is a Sheffield United player whose second name is that French sort of bun you have for breakfast, shaped like.
Croissant.
Yeah.
Oh, it's Ben.
Croissant, very good. Now, this is the referee whom you call Big Issue because you think he should be selling Big Issue.
Dermot Gallagher.
This is someone I think once shat in the loo when he played for Leicester.
Robbie Savage? You said it.
He's a light middleweight boxer whose name is not unadjacent to what Robbie Savage did.
Crapped.
Yeah, but when you what is the place you go to when you have a crap? Oh,
the loo.
The loo. Oh, yeah, you? And you what do you do in a loo?
Poo in the loo.
Yeah, but you you
dump.
Have a or you you.
I can say it.
You take a
poo.
Well, that's so close.
I won't give you that one. No.
This is an Indian bowler who recently destroyed England. His first name... that substance you smoke, Gary. The substance you smoke without the H on the front.
Heroin. like that.
We'll get just close again.
So Gary's team have moved on to 17. We'll allow you those 3 points from before.
So it's four now. So we have 13 to get. I suspect we might as well just roll out the victory bunting.
Okay, and your time.
Hold on.
Starts now.
Okay, this is an old mate of yours. I believe he was once shat on by a turtle.
Chris Akabusi.
There you go. Okay. This is a girl from Atomic Kitten who hates Gary, apparently. Liz.
Hardman.
McLaren, that's close.
Hardman McLaren.
All right, this is Oakland. Now, you see, there's nowhere to go with this.
Fish.
Well,
fish.
No, don't start there. You're going to get in trouble.
Come on, we'll get it.
First name is, it's an Australian word for throwing up.
Chunder.
No, but there's an actor called Fiennes, and his first
Ralph.
Name.
Ralph.
Yeah, that's it, Ralph. And the second name is... What? Go through the list, if you will, Sharron, of what you how you describe your ladies downstairs front bottom. What popular words are there for it?
My mum's watching.
Yeah, we don't know, but she...
You call it your mum's watching?
I find that quite erotic.
I'm not a turn-off, I've got to be honest.
If you burn the end of your hair... You
singe.
An inch.
Yeah.
I feel we could have got there sooner.
Oh, okay. This is, she's a runner, and she, I think when God was given that talent, she went twice to the speed queue and didn't go to the beauty queue. That's a nice way of putting it, I believe.
Don't look at me, you know exactly.
When you go to France, you go through the channel...
I'm not saying it.
You go through the channel...
I know one lady that it cannot possibly be.
Who could it not be? Who would not be?
It could not be Sally Gunnell, because she's too pretty and that.
It's Sally Gunnell. How did we arrive at that? I don't know. This, okay. This is a goalkeeper. His second name, it's what I am, it's what Gary never will be.
Cool. Gary's team have 8 for this week's win. It is Gary's team with 17. Now that means that the series score is tied, so it's tie-break time. Now, to decide the series, we'd like each team to come up with the number of revolting, depraved, perverted practices I have personally accused Rory of over the last 15 series, okay? Nearest win.
Can you give us an example then, Nick?
Sex with a sheep, for instance.
Does that count as one?
No, there can be more than one time.
Got a whole flock.
Don't write them down, Rory, because they're not all ones you've actually been convicted of. Some we just made up.
427.
Oh!
Did we not accuse him once of trying to a hole in the ozone layer? I think we did. I'm guessing it's in the high 50s.
Well, let's see who was closest. Nearest, they are the series winner. So, our thanks to Gary, Rory and Graham, Sharron, Jonathan and Roger. We're all off for 10 pints of Strongbow and a punch-up. My name's Nick Hancock, and it's all over. It is now.
In the company of a playboy, Ruby Wax gets close up to Hugh Hefner next on BBC One.